discuss about acute myocardial infarction and its management. Before starting the myocardial infarction, you should know what are the causes of acute chest pain in a normal human being. So we can see cardiac causes. Cardiac causes can be myocardial ischemia, that is angina, that is on the left side of the chest, you can get the pain, and pain may radiate to the left arm. Myocardial infarction or acute occlusion of the one of the coronaries can have severe chest pain. Then myocarditis, inflammation of myocardium, pericarditis, inflammation of the covering of the heart, mitral valve prolapse, aortic stenosis, aortic dissection, aortic aneurysm, all these things can produce pain in the heart. Whenever patient present with emergency room, to emergency room, you should think about these causes for chest pain. Now, other non-cardiac chest pain can be due to emotional condition like anxiety, fear, stress, GERD, pulmonary conditions like pulmonary embolism, pulmonary infarct, pleuritic chest pain, pneumonia, pneumothorax, chest malignancy, musculoskeletal condition like costochondritis, rib fracture, rib injury, intercostal muscle injury, intercostal neuralgia. All these things can present with chest pain. Remember, one of the skin condition which present with acute chest pain is herpes lesion in a diabetic patients. Most of the time you can see in the anterior chest or the lateral chest, you can have herpes lesions can produce acute present with severe chest pain. Okay, now we'll see acute myocardial infarction. Acute myocardial infarction is defined as a clinical condition where there is an acute occlusion of the coronaries and there is complete blockage of the blood supply to the myocardium, and there will be myocardial injury or necrosis and death of the myocardium. Acute coronary syndromes are, under acute coronary syndrome, you have three major diseases. One is ST elevation MI, another one is non-ST elevation MI, and third one is unstable angina. Okay, the first two things are characterized by, like ST elevation MI and non-ST elevation MI, you can have a elevated cardiac myocardium. Okay. Now we'll see the type of chest pain in acute myocardial infarction. The pain starts in the central chest and there is a tightening of sensation, and it may radiate to the left arm, okay, medial side of the left arm. It's a continuous pain. Pain lasts more than 30 minutes, and it can radiate to chest, throat, left arm, epigastrium, and even back. Okay, patient can have severe like anxiety, sweating, and there is a feeling of impending death, nausea, vomiting. All these things can associated with the chest pain. Some of the patients can have severe breathlessness because of left ventricular failure. Some patients can have collapse and syncope. This is also due to left ventricular failure or heart blocks. These are the symptoms. Okay. Now we'll see the signs of acute myocardial infarction. Signs are mainly because of sympathetic activation. Patient can have sweating, pallor, tachycardia. So there can be signs of vagal activation, like patient can have vomiting, bradycardia. Signs of impaired myocardial function, you can have hypotension, cold peripheries, narrow pulse pressure, raised JVP, third heart sound, and you can have bilateral lung crepitation because of the pulmonary edema. Okay, now you can see signs of tissue damage, like myocardium is injured, patient can have fever because of tissue inflammation. Signs of other complication like mitral regurgitation and pericarditis can be there in a patient with acute MI. Whatever it is, in initial presentation will be acute onset left-sided chest pain, which is not relieved with the salbutamol or rest, which may radiate to the left arm, and patient can present with severe chest pain. Okay, now we'll see the initial investigation in emergency room for an acute myocardial infarction. You have to take an ECG. Mostly ECG shows, suppose it's an ST elevation MI, we have discussed there are two types of MI, ST elevation MI and non-ST elevation MI. In ST elevation MI, you can see ST elevation or new bundle branch block. We'll see what is an ST elevation. ST segment elevation at J point in minimum two contiguous leads for more than 1 millivolt. In all other leads, it is you can have more than 0.1 millivolt ST elevation in the most of the leads, that is ST elevation MI. And sometimes you can see new onset left bundle branch block, that is also considered as a acute MI changes. Okay, now we'll see what is non-ST elevation MI. Previously, we have seen ST elevation MI that shows ST elevation in the anterior leads or inferior leads. Anterior leads means V1, V2, V3, V4. If you have ST elevation, you call it as acute anterior myocardial infarction. And in that cases, you get a reciprocal change in lead 2, 3 and AVF. There you can get ST depression. Whereas in inferior wall MI, you get ST elevation in lead 2, 3 and AVF. And you can get reciprocal change in V1, V2, V3, ST depression. Okay. So, but whereas in ST, non-ST elevation MI, you don't see any ST elevation in any of the leads in ECG, but you can see elevated cardiac enzymes. So, both in ST elevation MI and non-ST elevation MI, you can see cardiac enzymes are elevated. We'll discuss about cardiac enzymes later. Okay, so you have two types of MI, ST elevation MI, non-ST elevation MI. Both of these condition cardiac enzymes elevated. But if you are having a patient who is having acute chest pain, ECG shows ST depression or mild ST elevation and cardiac enzymes are not elevated, means it is unstable angina. Okay, now we'll see about cardiac enzymes in acute MI. Okay, there are two important cardiac enzymes. One is CKMB. It rises in first 4 to 8 hours and returns back to normal in first 48 to 72 hours. Okay, another set of cardiac enzyme is troponin T and I. Both will be elevated in 4 to 6 hours but return back to normal in 7 to 10 days. So remember, in a patient who is having acute MI and if he develops a re-MI, repetition of acute myocardial infarction during the admission period, his CKMB is the best choice for that condition. Okay, so reinfarction, the best investigation is CKMB. In acute MI, troponin I or T is the best investigation, but most of the emergency rooms do CKMB and troponin T and I. Okay, now we'll see what is the acute management of myocardial infarction in emergency room. Okay, so every patient who come to emergency room, you take care is airway, breathing, circulation. Okay, so you talk to the patient, patient is talking properly, his saturation is good, no need to start oxygen. Suppose the saturation is low due to some reason, like patient can have pulmonary edema, start him on oxygen, otherwise oxygen is not required. Okay, most of these patients will have severe chest pain, so treat the patient with morphine. You can give 2 to 5 milligram bolus initially, but remember always give metoclopramide along with the morphine, because morphine can produce severe vomiting. Okay, some of the patients can have bradycardia because of inferior wall MI, so don't try morphine in that type of patients. Otherwise, morphine is a good drug in acute myocardial infarction for pain. Okay, now we'll go for the next set of treatment. In a patient who is having acute myocardial infarction, after morphine you have to start on antiplatelets. Okay, so antiplatelets are normally, we start aspirin, that's a chewable tablet. Dispirin you can give, 300 milligram dispirin can be given, and then next day onwards you have to make it 150 milligram per day. So start dose of aspirin is 300 milligram. It should be only a soluble or chewable tablet, not a tablet which has got a coating. Ecosprin type of tablets are not indicated. Aspirin chewable tablets are indicated. Then you have to give clopidogrel, that is another antiplatelet, 300 milligram stat and 75 milligram per day to be continued. So 300 milligram aspirin, 300 milligram clopidogrel, and continuation doses aspirin 150 milligram and clopidogrel 75 milligram to be continued indefinitely. Okay, another newer drugs are prasugrel and ticagrelol. Ticagrelol loading dose is 180 milligram. It is available 90 milligram tablet. 180 milligram loading dose and 90 milligram should be continued continuously if the patient is taken for PCI. Okay, both prasugrel and ticagrelol is preferred drug over clopidogrel in a patient who is undergoing angiogram or angioplasty. Okay, now the next drug to be given in acute MI is beta blocker. It can reduce the demand of the myocardium, it can reduce the heart rate, and it increases the myocardial oxygen supply. Okay, increases the coronary perfusion, decreases the demand of oxygen. Metoprolol is the ideal drug to be given in acute myocardial infarction. 5 milligram IV can be given. Repeated dose can be given. 5 milligram first you give, then you can give second dose, third dose also can be given. After that, you should start the patient on metoprolol tablet, 12.5 milligram orally per day to be continued. Okay. The next drug to be started in acute myocardial infarction is statins. The preferred drug is atorvastatin, 80 milligram stat, and it should be continued 40 milligram every day. Okay. The intervention, suppose you have an intervention cardiac center in your hospital, you have to take the patient for primary percutaneous coronary intervention, that is angiogram and angioplasty can be done. Then if the patient comes less than 12 hours, immediately take the patient for angiogram and angioplasty. It is associated with a less than 50% reduction in the death comparing with the thrombolytic therapy. So it is better than thrombolysis. Now we'll talk about thrombolysis. Thrombolysis, you try to lyse the thrombus with streptokinase. Normal dose of streptokinase is 1.5 million units in 100 ml saline to be given over 1 hour. Okay, or you can go for Altiplase. The bolus of the Altiplase is 15 milligram followed by 0.75 milligram per kg body weight, but not exceeding 50 milligram. Okay, so that should be given over 30 minutes. That is thrombolysis. Okay, now once the patient is stabilized, when the patient is in ICU, you have to prevent propagation of thrombus or you have to give DVT prophylaxis. Heparin is the ideal drug to be given to prevent the propagation of thrombus. That can be given in a patient who is coming with acute MI after stabilization. Bolus dose of heparin is 60 to 70 units per kg, maximum 5000 units can be given, followed by an infusion 12 to 15 units per kg. Initial infusion rate will be 1000 units per hour. Okay, and you try to achieve an APTT of 50 to 70 seconds, that is the APTT to be achieved. Okay. Once the patient is stabilized in your ICU, you have to go for his follow-up treatment. Okay. So first thing is lifestyle modification. So patient has to stop smoking, reduction of alcohol intake, graded exercise should be advised, diet should be regulated according to his cholesterol levels. Drugs like aspirin 150 milligram with clopidogrel 75 milligram, or you can go for ticagrelol 90 milligram OD to be continued for 1 year, and 60 milligram per hour BD can be continued for following years. Beta blocker, metoprolol is the ideal drug to be continued. 25 to 50 milligram OD can be continued. AC inhibitors should be started in all patients with myocardial infarction to reduce the ventricular remodeling. So AC inhibitor, ideal AC inhibitor may be ramipril 2.5 to 20 milligram per day. You can start to be continued. Statins are another drug. You can give atorvastatin 40 milligram per day or rosuvastatin 20 milligram per day. Spironolactone is another drug which can prevent the ventricular remodeling. That should be continued. So we have discussed the management of acute myocardial infarction. Various drugs we have discussed. Thank you.